guys, and welcome back to my channel. And if this is your first time watching me, hi, my name is Janine, and I will have all of my socials linked down below. Make sure to subscribe and join the fam. Today's video is going to be another wig review. Today's is going to be this pink one, and I ordered this one on Amazon. Just like the other one, I will have that linked down below as well. That one was like a blue keely color. So this one is pink, and this is what it looks like. It was only $15 on Amazon. It was only $15 on Amazon, and we're gonna see, is it worth it? Or should you splurge on a more expensive wig to get better quality? Let's see. So initially, this one did not come with a wig cap like the first one did, but I don't really care about that because I already bought wig caps. But it is super long. I really like the feel of the hair, and it's not too shiny. Like, I know when a wig is super shiny, you know it's fake. With the lighting, it is a little bit, so you can always just spray dry shampoo on it to dull that. But in the natural lighting, it's not that bad, so I'm not gonna personally spray it down. And I like this one with the bangs a lot better because I'm not gonna have that problem with the part and trying to deal with making the part look natural. Since it does have bangs, which I did think of that initially when I bought it. I wanted one with bangs so I wouldn't have to deal with the whole part situation. Like, it just has this band around the entire thing, and then there are two adjustable straps down at the bottom. The hair is a bit spaced out in the front, but it's still a really full wig, which I'm glad because I want it to look natural on me. Since I have thick hair, I need a wig that has thick hair. And the head of this wig seems a lot smaller than like average. So I don't know if I'm even gonna tighten it at all because I think this will be too small anyways. I'm gonna secure this in with some bobby pins real quick, and I'll be right back. So I've got that secured in with this. I think I'm definitely going to cut these bangs because, like, if you pull them off to the side, like, that could be a look and it would be fun, but there's not enough, like, room to make this part right here look natural. So I would need to make them straight across bangs, and they are way too long for that. I do wish that the bang section was wider. I'm not understanding why there's only bangs. Like, there's this short piece right here, and then there's these bangs, and then the rest of it, and then it just goes straight to being long right here. And that's just weird to me. I don't understand why. Now, I would recommend getting like actual hair scissors. I don't have any with me today, so I'm just using these. Now, if you have never cut hair before, I would recommend asking someone who does to do it for you. Just because, like, with cutting your own hair, it can grow back. So it doesn't really matter if you mess up, but with this, it's not gonna grow back. So if you mess up, it's kind of done for. But you just want to see the part where you want it, like the length that you want it to be. Put your fingers there. So I want it to be right here. And then I'm going to cut it to my finger at an angle. Because you don't want it to go just straight across, because that'll make it look more fake. Still want it a little bit shorter, so I'm going with it again. And I like this so much more now that I cut the bangs, because now they can just go straight across, don't have to worry about blending or any of that. And it is a very long wig. I love it. The hair is super soft. It's keeping its curl. I now have pink hair all over my dress. I should have planned ahead. I didn't plan on cutting this wig today, so I didn't put a towel underneath me, so I'm going to need a vacuum, but it's fine. But yeah, I am definitely happy with this, with cutting it. And so if I didn't do that good of a good job explaining it before, if you want to cut your wig, you're just gonna put your fingers right across where you want to cut. So if you want, like, if you want to cut this and have a face frame, then just put your fingers above where you want it to be once you cut it, and then cut at an angle. And when you're cutting this way, you're gonna cut at an angle downward, and then with, like, straight across bangs, or if you're just gonna cut it, like, short like this, then you're gonna want to cut it at an angle upward, so it looks like it just flows across, not just like a straight across line. But for being a $15 wig, this is really good. I am not getting a lot of fallout with just, like, bringing my hands through it. There's like a couple pieces here and there, but it's not bad at all. It feels really nice. It's really thick, really soft. Like, I don't have any issues with this wig. The only thing was the bangs were too long. I cut them, no big deal. It took me like 5 minutes. So I definitely think it's worth it to get this wig for only 15 bucks and not splurge on a super expensive pink wig, especially because, like, colored hair, the trends always come and go. So it's not worth it to spend a lot of money on a wig that you might not wear as often as you think you will. So I hope this video helped you guys out with learning how to cut wigs. Maybe you want to buy this wig. Whatever you choose, I will make sure to link this wig down below if you do want to purchase it. So leave a comment down below if there's any other videos you want me to do. If there's any wig you want me to try out, let me know down below. Make sure to give this video a like if you liked it. And subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I will see you next week.